Hello everyone, Husseini Academy welcomes you once again. I have brought you another topic to discuss, to throw light on this. Okay, so in other videos I have discussed about multiple literary groups, multiple literary societies, multiple literary committees, multiple literary movements. In this video I am going to talk about confessionalism. I am talking about confessional poetry. So before I deliver my lecture, something which are very important to understand, you must be acquainted that if you understand different literary groups and different literary societies and different literary movements, it will broaden your perspective and it will provide you ability to understand different types of literature easily. Okay, so in this video, the topic which I have brought is very, very important for your NET and for other exams if you are a student of literature. So I will talk about confessional poetry. So before I speak and before I define this particular literary groups, you need to know that writers like Shakespeare, like William Wordsworth, like Coleridge and all the romantic writers, they subjectively produce their work, means they try to depict their personal psychological experiences of life. They wrote in their works whatever they faced, whatever they encounter, whatever they went through, they tried to put in their work. That is why you will notice personality involvement in their works. Like let me give you examples so that it may be more comprehensible when you study the works of William Wordsworth, Prelude. So that is autobiographical, means he has tried to put his personal experiences in that particular work. Okay, so there was a tradition earlier in literature to produce a literary work subjectively. Okay, but when the age of modernism appeared on the screen of literature, T.S. Eliot, he criticized traditional writers and especially romantic writers. He says that they have a subjectively produced, means they have provided their personal psychological emotional dimension of life in their work. That should not be, it should not be part of work, it should not be part of literature, it should not be part of work. So he criticized and he says that writers should be away from his writing. Writer should not be part of his work. He should write whatever he has seen in that particular society in which he has lived around, but he should not try to provide his personal personal experiences and psychological experiences. Okay, so he should be away. Personality involvement should not be. It was a completely rejected by T.S. Eliot. T.S. Eliot, that's why, gave a theory, and theory you know very well, the theory of impersonality, that was given by T.S. Eliot, in which he says that writer should be away from his work, writer should not be part of his work, writer should be separated from his work. Later what happened, as I told you, that action and reaction makes developmental process. Development is outcome of action reaction process. If there is no action and there is no reaction, there will not be development. So what happened later, that around 1959, a work which was published by Robert Lowell, Life Studies, it dismantled the notion given by T.S. Eliot, in which the writer Robert Lowell tried to depict his personal life. He tried to involve his personal experiences in his work. And that is why when M.L. Rosenthal wrote review of this book entitled as Poetry as a Confession, he appreciated and wrote that this is a personal document, means that there is personal involvement, personality involvement, personal experiences, psychological experiences, emotional experiences are the part of this work. So the group of writer which followed the tradition created, given by Robert Lowell, Life Studies, they came to be called as confessional writer and confessional poet. Some of writer associated with this particular group are Salvia Plath, Anna Sexton and W.D. Snodgrass. They are very, very important writer. Okay, they shaped this literary tradition of American poetry. They were appreciated because it was very open type, open revelation of their personal experiences. They believe that writers should focus on their personal experiences and personal psychological experiences of life, emotional dimension of life, he should put in his work. So it was just opposite to the tradition, the theory given by T.S. Eliot. Okay, so I think the concept is clear to you, the definition is clear to you. Okay, but I think that another definition which have been given by M.H. Abraham, I should discuss with you so that it may be more comprehensible to you, it may be more accessible to you. M.H. Abraham says in his book, confessional poetry as a type of narrative and lyrical verse given impetus by American Robert Lovell's life studies, which deals with the fact and intimate mental physical experiences of poets and own life. So that was definition given by M.H. Abraham. Okay, that is confessional poetry, means representation of one's own life, depiction of personal psychological experiences of life. Okay, that was given by M.H. Abraham. Okay, so the definition is clear, and it came as a response to literary theory, literary tradition propounded by T.S. Eliot, the theory of impersonality, in which book he has propounded, he has mentioned about this particular theory. You write into comment box, you need to mention, okay, you mention about that. I will not tell you about each and everything, at least you should try to find out something. So it was a response to theory of impersonality. Okay, let's study about some characteristic. When we study characteristics, we come across the self-revelation, that is a part of this type of literary works, literary tradition. Mean they try to reveal their personal experiences and psychological level of life and experiences they went through, they encounter. The psychological experiences and traumas they went through, they encounter, they try to put in their work, that is visible from their works. And another point is that autobiographical nature. So their works has autobiographical nature, means autobiographical element are clear, directly presented, okay, directly written. So they have tried to put it, far. They have trying to take it out. And first person narration, okay. So that is why you study when poems written by a confessional poet, you read, you will find it start with I. You will come across I multiple times, because it is personal, first person narrative, and the writer has narrated his or her life, in that work, in that particular work. Intimate subject matter means that intimate physical whatever, something, in our society there are multiple things which we do not want to share with anyone, like personal relationship, like sex, like other thing which are related to our psychological life, we should not discuss with anyone. But they openly discuss. It is embarrassing, but they did not think it is embarrassing. They openly discuss about each and every such topic, sex, personal relationship, psychological traumas, they discuss. And another point, lyrical craftsmanship, really remarkable, remarkably produced, mean stylistically it is appreciated. Okay, so these are writers which I have written: Sylvia Plath, okay, Annie Sexton, John Berryman, Allen Ginsberg, W.D. Snodgrass. They are really important writers. You can take the example how Sylvia Plath has revealed his personal experiences, psychological traumas in this poem written by her. Daddy, I have had to kill you. You died before I had time. So this is amazing works written by Sylvia Plath, and other works by other writers associated with this particular group. They have tried to put their life, before the reader. So it was the entire lecture about it. I hope that you like this video. If you like this video, share, subscribe, so that you may get another video which is about to come, which I'm going to publish. Good to see you. Thank you very much for listening this video.